The adverse weather that impacted Trinidad and Tobago over the past 24 hours has resulted in flooding in several communities. The Office of Disaster Preparedness has asked persons to take shelter and be extremely vigilant of rising floodwaters. Karen Cozier-Phillip reports.
The Office of Disaster Preparedness and Management has advised persons to shelter in place and delay travel until further assessments can be conducted of the nation's roadways. The ODPM says reports identified flooding impacting the following areas: Churchill Roosevelt Highway between Orange Grove Road to O'Meara Road, Arima, St. Helena Bypass Road, Aripo near the Detention Center, Aruka near Thomas Trace, Madras Road, Southern Main Road, Karani South Bank Road, Karani Savannah Road, Endeavour Road, Penal Rock Road, Clark Road, and San Francisco Road. The ODPM appeals to people to desist from driving or walking through floodwaters and to seek alternative routes where possible. Meanwhile, the Chicoanas Borough Corporation has advised that the Marchin Bridge in Jerningham Junction, Karani, has been compromised and is closed until further notice. Additionally, the Canupia River has overflown its bank, resulting in flooding in the surrounding areas, including the Diet Estate. And the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government says it has reports of landslides affecting the Maturo Road and the Grand Revere River and the Shark River breaching their banks. The ministry says 14 disaster management units remain on high alert and continue to assist people who may be trapped in their homes due to flooding or landslides. Members of the public are asked to utilize the 24-hour toll-free DMU hotline numbers to report any emergencies related to flooding, landslides, and fallen trees. Karen Cozier-Phillip, TTT News.
And the Met Office has moved the riverine alert to red level. On the phone now is head of the Office of Disaster Preparedness and Management, Captain Neville Wint. Captain Wint, good evening. And what does this mean now that we're at red level alert?
Good afternoon to Trinidad and Tobago. The red level alert means that there's a high risk of extreme danger or casualties that may be unavoidable, even in unusual safe places. Persons should basically try to shelter in place and be extra vigilant, as the Met Office has issued this riverine red alert. I need to identify to the Trinidad and Tobago that the Met Office is the legal authority for issuing this alert. And this alert would last from 6 p.m. this afternoon to 12 p.m. on Friday, the 26th of October. We expect that the current river levels in some cases have already exceeded their threshold, and we expect more of this to occur. Persons in low-lying areas should also expect water levels to rise, and we ask persons to really be vigilant and take the necessary precaution to preserve life, most of all.
And can you also update us on any of the areas that are being impacted at this time, and have any shelters been opened?
At this point in time, the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government has identified two shelters in the beach and also the Tunapuna area. The Aruka Community Center has been opened thus far to take persons who are marooned in other areas. What we have received almost impact reports from 11 municipal corporations, and the Ministry of Rural Development has raised their alert level to level 2, which means a greater proportion of those corporations are impacted. The Trinidad Tobago Defense Force, Trinidad Tobago Fire Service, the Ministry of Works and other social responder agencies are in the field executing life-saving rescues at this point in time, and we are trying to respond to the needs. I would also inform the public to be a bit patient as the agencies try to get to them based on the report that we receive. They are also struggling with clogged roadways, with vehicles, and impassable roadways based on how water is traveling. But at this point in time, the ODPM, along with all the other response agencies, is making the effort to get to those persons who are in need, and we are operating on a life-saving priority.
Thank you so much, Captain Wint.